You know I stepped in the water, and the water was cold. God's gonna trouble the water. I shed a tear, my water, not my soul. God's gonna trouble the water. You know what? When slaves were escaping, if they got into the water, the hounds couldn't pick up their scent, really. And so they could find a way to escape if they didn't drown, and they can wade in the water and get near the shallow part and just hide and then walk across, helping one another, picking up the children and doing what they need to do to escape to freedom. Water is still a place of freedom. It reminds us of the water, the washing of the word, the washing of water by the word of God. It reminds us of the well that springs up in us. Spring up a well in my soul. It reminds us of how Jesus is the living water. Yes, you know, the body needs water, and it's mostly water, and how it's important to stay hydrated. Well, it's important to stay spiritually hydrated so we don't get dry. And sometimes it's not only good to take it in, but to splash the water on our face and on our legs. It just reminds us of it. You know, I don't know if it's like being in the womb where we were relaxing on our mother's, in our mother's stomach, but it's just something just so peaceful. Something just so peaceful about the water. You know, side note, if they couldn't catch a scent while they were escaping and they were in the water, what if somebody had really stinky feet? Like, God, I used to live on my block. Oh my gosh, his feet were so stinky that it would come through his shoes. I don't think he would escape, because, well, maybe he would, because the dogs would just turn the other way and just run, or just maybe kill over. That's not a nice thing to say about this guy. He has gone on to glory, but what a wonderful singer he was. And I don't know if there's some kind of special thing that people sometimes have really smelly feet. So you really gotta stay in the water. Sometimes our sin is like that. You know, we just can't get that one time. We got to dip again. We got to remind ourselves. We got to keep going into the Word of God, so it can just keep renewing us and keep and washing things off of us. You know, we got to keep going to that place where we can get fresh water, because sometimes we wash, that water gets dirty, and we got to start with some clean water. Yes, let's work out our salvation with fear and trembling. Let's be serious about this thing. Let's die daily. Let's crucify ourselves in Christ. And let's just go through just the introspection or reflection, whatever we need to do, so that once we get all nice and clean and the murky water is cleared and we get clean water, we can just see blue, beautiful water. All the murkiness is gone. All the dirtiness is gone. When the Holy Ghost leads us into truth in our inward parts, you know, it's just like with fire. You know, you can get to a place that something is so clean and clear that when that refiner looks into that water that he's been not the water, what is he cleaning? Is that he's putting it in the refiner's fire? And when, oh yes, and when he takes off all that murky stuff, he just scums off the murky stuff, and he picks up that precious metal. But even before he picks up the precious metal, that it is so clear after the murky stuff is gone, you can actually see. God can see himself. Sometimes when he takes us through the fire and he gets all the murky stuff off of our precious metal, the gold is going to shine, and it's going to take away the tin and it's going to make us clean and new and fresh again. Anyway, That's a lot of thoughts, but may you be blessed. I'm just brainstorming it on my walk today, and I ended it with just putting my feet in the pool. May something here I've said in several videos. I hope you have a chance to look at those several videos and consider, you know, subscribing and coming back. And I know it's something always new. It's kind of like I am kind of eclectic and kind of different things, though. So you won't find just one thing, but whatever, you will find something that you like, that you can come back to, that you can remind yourself of, and that you can share with someone else. God bless you. Have a wonderful day. I hope you get to put your feet in the water sometime. God bless.